Imagine this realm being the submarine. We're all in the submarine having fun, and we're doing our thing, and we have disagreements here and disagreements there. And then we find out there's a hole in the sub, but the hole is not, we thought the hole was in the sub, but it wasn't in the submarine itself. It was in fact in the people. The people's water inside their bodies began to increase based on their emotions. Let's just say that. And the dark matter can then come into this realm through people. That's in fact what they discovered in 1950, that people can also produce dark matter by way of, it's very minute, it's very tiny, but it's measurable, it's quantifiable. In fact, they now know how much energy a person has to have before they go absolutely berserk. They also know how much of that energy signature a person must have before an entity from that realm can possess them, which also allowed them to understand that not everybody can be possessed. Not everybody can be, but the person has to be prepared to be possessed. They have to be, in essence, they have to be a portal themselves to be possessed. Not everybody can be possessed. And so, not to get way off target, but this dark matter is everywhere. That is, that, you know what, all these things, here's what, I mean, it really gets to me, is that these scientists, over the course of many years, have quantified, or they have calculated these things. They have extracted the truth, the facts, yet the Christians don't believe it. And these crooked people in certain places have already been harnessing this power for themselves, and it's been effective every single step of the way. Yet the Christian community, for some reason, has a mental block on certain things of God, as though they have all the time in the world to, you know, I will say this, and then I'll be back to CERN, that if a person trusts their father, they don't need the father to explain everything. They just need the father, they just need to know that the father said it, and they'll go do it. If you tell a child, go, you need to go rake the yard, a child's not going to sit there and say, well, what brings you to that conclusion? A child's not going to do that. You'll just go out there and rake the yard. Over time, you'll find out why, but you have already performed what the father said. And but in the Christian community, we have to know why everything is before we do anything. In the scientific community, they see the facts. They know they don't understand it fully, and so they have experiments, and they learn along the way. In fact, they're obedient to their own disciplines, and we're not obedient to our own disciplines. So the problems about CERN, I know everybody's waiting on this. What could potentially happen from this? Well, they had another discovery that dark matter causes other pieces of dark matter that they have contained to react. In other words, if you have a container, say you had a teaspoon of dark matter, and let's just say you had it in Pennsylvania, and somebody else had that same a teaspoon of dark matter in California, then as soon as the teaspoon of dark matter is exposed to the elements in Pennsylvania, it causes the dark matter in California to begin to activate. In other words, you lose containment in one place, containment in another place is going to be lost. It's going to be lost. So they're intimately tied together. Now, we've covered the fact that people have the signatures of the energy of dark matter in them and matter. So they contain both matter and antimatter, in a sense, the signature of energy. They're not put together. It's just that signature. And we draw upon those based upon our thoughts and what's in our minds and what's in our hearts, in a sense. With CERN, as they begin to collide these protons, dark matter is going to be produced in great numbers, in greater and greater numbers. Not only the matter, but the energy signature is going to also be released into this realm. You know what that's going to cause? It's going to cause the dark energy signature within people to begin to activate more and more. You see? going to become difficult for people to stay contained or controlled. In essence, they're going to become violent. They're going to have vivid dreams. The darkness within a person is absolutely going to begin to surface. And this is not theoretical. This is not some theory somebody thought of. This is absolutely 100% quantifiable, and it's happened before. It's going to happen in greater numbers this time. It will take effect. That's also been weaponized. Nobody knows this, and I probably won't be in trouble for this, but they have a weapon concerning dark matter that they can put within a country or a specific place to cause chaos. It's a weapon. They've used it before. They can unleash this, and it can cause chaos anywhere they want chaos to be rampant. Also, there's something very important about that. I know this firsthand. There are oftentimes you have to partake in the weapons development program, and you become a rat, so to speak, in a maze, to see firsthand what the effects are going to be. I'll describe something. People can believe it or not, but sooner or later they're going to experience it too. I am a Christian. I know that Jesus died on the cross for the remissions of sins and now sits at the right hand of the Father, soon to be sent to us again. I rely on the blood of the Lamb. I am, as a soldier, I count my Lord and Savior as my commander. And so I am used to taking orders and to operate life or death in those orders that he gave. That's the only thing that saved my life one day. I was thrust into a position where I had to absolutely 100% fight to keep my flesh under full subjection. I could not believe the intensity of what was happening. My thoughts were all over the place. It was almost like every evil thing that was in me came to the surface with a snap of a finger. Irritation, aggravation, anxiety, fear, just anger, hatred, all sorts of things in the snap of a finger. The only thing that kept me still, the challenge was to be still. The only thing that kept me still, I had to absolutely 100% focus on the Lord. I had to focus on. It's the only way to overcome that is to focus on him and place the flesh under subjection. If a person's out there and they say, well, I have no power to control myself. Yes, you do. You don't want to control yourself. Believe me, that power is within you, is given through the Holy Spirit. I felt the power, the protective power, the blood of the Lamb and the Holy Spirit during that test. I was amazed. I didn't know this could be harnessed in that way. I did not know, but it happened. And this was a weapon. This was a mild weapon. And you have to cling, people have to cling to the Word of God and his promises. Most importantly, his instruction. Not one time when I was in that test, I didn't think about his promises. I thought about his love. That's what I thought about. And when I began to think about his love, something happened within me. Everything came under subjection as though it took no effect. That's what happened. They found the force that holds the dark energy or the dark matter away from this realm. They call it the wall. There's another name for that. A name of which that those particles they're going to find, they found part. They're going to find the other pieces that are in that wall. And when they find the other pieces to this wall, they will then be able to undo that wall. There's another name for that wall. The veil. Call it the veil. It holds back that realm. They found out what's holding back the dark energy from, because it would be absolutely destructive if the two met. But they found out, now with this as a weapon, there is no counter weapon to this. China is building an LHC facility. They're building a particle accelerator. There are, to present day count, about 14 particle accelerators in existence. 14, not just one. All the countries are vested in the CERN facility, every single last country. The United States, we have three facilities here. Three. I can't tell you where they are. One, they began to build, but they couldn't, but they went ahead and built it anyway. It's in one of the biggest states in the United States, and it's there and it's operational. It's also going to be powered up during this time. I'm saying this because when this thing does power up, the immediate effects are not what I'm worried about. That's not my concern. The psychological effects on people is going to become quite evident. And I know that people will come under some strange attacks, some strange occurrences and incidents. I know that the only way they can be protected from such things is their unqualified belief in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. You can't fake it. There is no substitute. People know if a person is real or not because they emit a different energy. That energy is that wall that this other realm cannot breach. It can't breach it. And there it's absolutely going to take effect. The collider, think of a collider as hundreds of nuclear explosions taking place within 1 second in their containment. It goes beyond fusion. It's in a realm by itself when they collide protons. They are going to find these particles, and within months, they're going to put into motion what we talked about today, and people are going to feel these effects. And then this other realm is going to begin to spill over in multiple places everywhere. Violence will increase. The crucial side of this is that with this show coming up, people are going to realize all too painfully what we've talked about today, but they have to start now. They really have to. They can't make excuses for their flesh anymore.
Shalom. I'm not going to be able to do that.